I'm Corinne.
I'm Thomas.
Good morning. Welcome to the Chill Spot. My name's Drake and this is Corinne.
Good morning.
We wanted to take some time today to talk a little bit about kind of CNA to CNA communication, how to handle if someone's talking back to you or giving you attitude, and what can happen if you do that. We had a question from one of our members, back talking or talking back about your boss. Back talking or talking about your boss, can it get you fired? So let's talk about that a little bit, because I think, again, there's no yes or no answer to this question, but there's a few different ways we could look at it.
Right.
Right. So I would say, ultimately, if it was up to me, and I was your boss, if you were talking back to me, I personally, and I have done this, I try to figure out, why are you talking to me that way? What's going on? If it becomes a regular thing, we're going to look at other things. Insubordination is a big thing, and many of you probably have heard that word in the building. It's basically respect, you know? You respect your boss, respect your peers. Don't look at it as a boss. Let's kind of rephrase this. Can talking about anyone or talking back to anyone in your center get you terminated?
Right, and it could.
It definitely could.
It could. I think it would really cause a lot of turmoil on the floor. You know, I've always heard the saying, well, you earn respect. Well, sometimes that's not going to happen in your work.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not.
Well, it's not in there.
You can't demand that.
You can never demand respect. And I've been in a lot of people builder trainings. We called them. There are two ways to look at respect. And people usually look at it two different ways, especially in the work industry. I'm the type of person, you don't earn respect with me. When we meet, you have it. Here's your respect. Can it diminish? Of course. But I like to start with it here. Some people you do, in fact, have to, for lack of a better term, earn their respect.
Right.
It is better to look at it as kind of like a mutual. You're right in the middle. Of course, you don't disrespect them, but you don't have a strongly earned respect for them. So, yeah, it's kind of
like
earned,
a trust
it's kind of not. Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
So you can definitely get fired. Union employees, we don't touch much on union. Let's reiterate, we are not a union.
Correct.
And union employees is a little different. We are not 100% educated in the union. And since we are not a union, we're not going to go too far into it. But union employees, it's different because you have different people protecting your job.
Right.
Contract employees, it's going to be a little different if you're in a contract. And so different kind of employees, government employees. But ultimately, at the end of the day, companies write most of their policies in a way that you, in fact, can be terminated if it's bad enough what you're saying or what you're doing. Let me tell you, if you're doing it in front of a resident, most likely you're going to be terminated.
Right, exactly. And if you do have a problem, why don't you just go and knock on the person's door and say, hey, do you have a moment to talk to me and work it out? It's, you know, why carry your emotions with you all through the day?
A huge thing, I'm always preaching peer-to-peer interaction, you know? We've talked about this on previous shows. When you have an issue, that is exactly what you want to do. You want to address it. You don't want to go talk to someone else about it, because I'll tell you, what's going to happen is they're going to go talk to someone else, and they're going to go talk to someone else. And by the time it gets to probably the second person, it's totally different than what you said, or they're perceiving it different from how you meant it to be. Go to that person. Hey, Corinne, I don't like how you talked to so-and-so this morning, blah, blah, blah. You know, you talk about it with them. If you're not getting anywhere, have someone come in and mediate the conversation.
Right.
Adults, fully professional people do it often. If you need a mediator in your conversation, do it. They're not there to take sides. They're just there to make sure the conversation continues to move in a positive way. And your mediator should allow you a little bit to bring up the negative, but they are there to make sure that only the negative is brought up if there is a solution.
Exactly. And once you have that meeting, leave it. It's over with and done. When you walk out of that office and that door shuts, it's over with. Just, you know, brush it off. It'll come off in the wash.
Yep.
You know, just don't pay no attention to
it.
You know. So hopefully we answered that question to the best of our ability. And one of the other questions was, what if the statement is true?
Again, it doesn't matter, true or not, if it's something that you feel like is going to cause conflict, I'm going to bet you money, probably is. There's a lot of true things that are said. Every single one of us as caregivers, there has been true things that have been said about us that we don't want someone going and repeating. Also, every single one of us has found trust in someone at some point through our career that we've later learned maybe you shouldn't have been talking about with them. So if it's true, if it's false, gossip is gossip. It's as simple as that. If you're not addressing the person or the issue directly, don't talk about it.
Exactly. And be careful who you vent to, because sometimes the people that you're venting to, their ears will grow legs and be carrying it on to the next person and into the break room. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of like that game.
Telephone?
I don't know. Yeah, it's like, I'm going to tell one person.
And that's exactly what I was thinking about.
And the time you get it around,
well, and that's why buildings changes. Tell you, mm-hmm. you don't, there's no venting. I will tell my employees that, don't vent. Go to the person that has a solution.
Exactly.
If they can't fix the problem, why are you talking to them about it? Unless they are a part of it and you're getting their input, but it should be constructive and positive, and you should be taking it to the decision maker, as I like to call them.
Exactly. Don't be the problem. Be part of the solution.
Exactly.
You know, to fix it. So. What's
that they say? Yeah, if you are not part of the problem, then you're part of the solution. There's no in the middle.
Right. Right, exactly. So we hope that we answered those questions.
Talk about people at work in a negative
way,
and you
won't have to worry about your job. Just praise each other. One thing that I've noticed as a CNA, we are not judgmental about who we take care of, but we discriminate so much against our other coworkers.
Oh, geez, yes.
I mean, it's like backstabbing and everything. We just need to come together and recognize that, you know, everyone is in this profession for a certain reason, and just stop the drama and just support each other. And that's how we're going to get more CNAs to come into our future.
Yes, I agree.
You know, so you have anything else you want to comment on? Okay. Well, I'm trying to think of a nice way to end the show.
I think just a normal one. Remember, until next time, you matter.